Okay, it's about 8:30 in the morning. I am at a completely different park for me. This is a very old baseball field. Opened in 1898. And it's smack dab in the ghetto. So I'm hoping all the muggers are asleep. I can give it a few hours here and then hightail it out. Let's see what happens. And if you can read this sign, with the graffiti all over it. But they had major league teams playing here in the 1920s, 1930s. They had exhibition games played here. So it's quite historic. And it's still a baseball field after all these years. So there might be some old stuff in here. Or it might be a lot of bottle caps. We'll have to see. And here's the first old coin today. It's a 1940 Wheaty. That was fairly deep. I don't know if you can see this, but the ground is all frosted over. But the dirt's not frozen, so it's fairly easy to dig here, and it's kind of sandy. And there's tons of clad here. I could probably spend all day picking up clad here. Alright, so far, I kind of doubt this place has been detected lately anyway, because there's tons of clad here. I've already found a couple bucks. I've only been here less than half hour. And some of it's pretty deep. This looks like another wheat penny. $46. Okay, this is seriously awesome here. I was just digging a high tone and look what I got. Oh yeah, it is a class ring, and I have never found one of these before. Please let it be gold. It's from 2006. Dunbar. Hold on a second. Let me check this out. All right, this might be a letdown here. Dunbar something school here. There's the mark. That's the only mark inside. I don't know what that means. Somebody's initials. And there's no gold or sterling marks on this. So I'm thinking it might be a plated ring. It's fairly heavy. Man, be nice if it was at least sterling. I don't know. I think this might be a cheapy ring. Okay, I think I got some success here. Unless it's just an unusually shiny clad dime. Where'd it go? There we go. Up. We got success. There is silver coins in here. And it's a 42. I'm not gonna rub it too much. So that's cool. That gives me hope. Well, this gave a beautiful quarter signal. And it looks like an old music box. Well, part of a music box. These are the keys. Right there. This is the motor. Oh well. Got a lot of ground to cover here. Alright, I just got some sort of aluminum token here. Very crusty. Yeah, I can't read it. It's something about Mark Twain, Mississippi, boat. Something. It's aluminum and it's all crusty. Okay, here was a surprise. I thought this rang up just like a clad quarter. And it's a silver Roosevelt. It's a 52. I'm finding tons of clad here. Deep, deep clad. There's somebody's nice doggy. So that's it, I'm taking a break. Maybe I'll come back and keep swinging, maybe I'll leave, I don't know. Part of our trash so far. I got tons of bottle caps. These thingies, I don't know what those are. Tons of bottle caps. Pieces of pipe. Okay, I've been here digging clad. Nothing but clad. And I just got a beautiful screaming high tone here. And I haven't even picked it up yet. It's right here. Oh, it's a piece of junk. Damn. Thought that was a coin. Ah, hell. Well, it's this kind of day. 8-inch clad quarters. And even the clad quarters are toasted. I can't even read it. Can't even read the date on that. I was dreaming of big silver coins, baseball player rings, But this is the reality. That's enough for me. I'm all done for the day. Here's the results. I got 26 quarters. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 dimes. I got the Roosevelt dime, the Merc, and this ring here. 2006 school ring. I don't know what this mark is in here. It looks like an SB. I think it's stainless or plated. I don't know. Feels heavy, but it's not marked silver and not marked gold. So I'm thinking it's stainless or plated. Got a little stone on there. 6 wheat pennies. These are all memorials. I threw most of my junk out already. I got a little bit more. And that's it. See you next time.